Welcome to the revision session on Chapter 3 Loaders. The loader is a system program which acts as the program and prepares them for execution. The loader performs four functions. First, allocates space in memory. Second, resolves symbolic reference between object X. Third, adjusts all addresses to the allocated space. And fourth, physically places the machine instruction and data into memory. General loader scheme. In this scheme, the source program is converted to object program by a translator. The loader receives these object modules and puts data in memory. Advantages are, there is no need to retranslate the program each time. As a loader occupies a portion of memory, there is no wastage of memory because loader is smaller than assembler. And the source program can be written with multiple languages. Disadvantages are, if the program is modified, it has to be retranslated and some portion of memory is occupied by the loader. Compile and go loader. In this, an instruction is read line by line. Its machine code is directly put into main memory. That means the assembler runs in one part of memory and assembled instruction data are directly put into their assigned locations. It is simple to implement. It also has few disadvantages. First, some portion of memory is occupied by the assembler, which is simply a wastage of memory. Second, source program need to be assembled and executed each time, which is a time-consuming activity. And third, it cannot handle multiple programs written in different languages. And the execution time will be more. It is also called as assemble and go loader. Absolute loader. The function of this loader is to take the output and load it into memory. And it is explained with a diagram consisting of two subroutines, main and square root. The programmer must be careful not to assign a subroutine to same location. In this, programmer must specify the address where program is to be loaded. If there are multiple subroutines, programmer must know the address of each. What is a subroutine linkage method? The way in which computer makes it possible to call and return from subroutine is referred as subroutine linkage method. It requires two instructions associated with the subroutine and they are call and return. The instruction used in calling the subroutine is either BAL or BALR and the format is given with an example here. The first argument is register number and second argument is the address. Return instruction is the unconditional jump to an address contained in a register. Relocating loader. Relocating loader is introduced to avoid reassembling of all subroutines when a single subroutine is changed and also to perform the task of allocation and linking. In this, transfer vector is used that consists of address containing names of subroutines referenced by the source program. For example, if square root routine was referenced, the first location of transfer vector contained the symbolic name SQRT. But transfer vector is only useful for transfer and it increases the size of program in memory. Direct linking loader. The direct linking loader has the advantage of allowing the programmer multiple procedure segments and multiple data segments. And it gives a freedom in referencing data and instruction contained in other segments. Thereby, it provides flexible inter-segment referencing and also accessing ability. The assembler generates four types of cards. First, EST, External Symbol Dictionary. It contains information about all the symbols that are defined in the program but referenced somewhere. Second, TXT, Text Card. It contains object code. And third, RLD, Location and Linkage Directory. It contains information about location in the program. END, it indicates the end of the program. A disadvantage of direct linking loader is that it is necessary to allocate, relocate, link and load all subroutines each time to execute a program and it is time consuming process. It is solved by dividing the loading process into binder and module loader. A binder is a program that performs the same functions as direct linking loader in binding subroutines together. But rather than placing the relocated and linked text directly into memory, it outputs the text as a file. The output file is ready to be loaded and is called load module. The module loader has to load the module into core. The binder performs allocation, relocation and linking and module loader performs the function of loading. Dynamic loading. The process of loading the subroutines of a program when required instead of loading all subroutines at once. It is useful in memory usage since many subroutines may not be called at all. If all the subroutines needed are loaded into memory at the same time, if memory required by these subroutines exceeds the available memory space, then problem occurs. Dynamic loading is used to solve this problem. Overlays. By recognizing which subroutines call other subroutines, it is possible to produce an overlay structure. But what is an overlay? An overlay is more piece of data that can be loaded to memory on demand. Overlays are useful where the system has limited RAM resource. These data are independent to each other and only required at specific times. Thus, system may achieve higher runtime performance.